Hey guys, Patricia Zars here. I help real estate agents and entrepreneurs make positive moves in their business, reach higher levels of success, all while creating a life that they love. Today I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about back to school. It is mid-August, teachers are going back to school, kids are going back to school, and parents are getting those kids ready. And this is a great opportunity for you as a real estate agent to brand yourself, become known in the community, and help out at the schools. So it's a great time for you to focus a lot of your marketing on back to school. And you can do this both within the school itself, with teachers and staff, as well as with parents. So there's several things you can do and you can implement into your marketing this time of year that can really help get yourself known within the community. So first, actually, if you want to market to the teachers and the staff, there's lots of fun and creative ways that you can swing by the school. I always like to contact the schools first, and obviously if you've got kids, I would start with the schools where your kids attend, but if you don't, focus on the area where you like for your clients to be in, the area that you want your future listings and your future home buyers to be in, and focus on those schools, and really just pick one or maybe two, because you want to be able to be consistent with your efforts and really put forth enough into it that it's going to make a difference. So I love doing pop buys at schools. So you can put together some little pop buys for the teachers that you can either put in their boxes if they'll let you, or you can leave them with the staff and they will put them in the boxes. One thing I love to do is pick up donuts or tacos or something and take those by and have those in the break rooms for the teachers to get either in the morning or as they're taking their breaks throughout the day. Another good thing that you can do to get some really great exposure with both the teachers, the staff, and the parents is to sponsor a sports team or advertise in their local bulletins or at the field. So this is a great way to get yourself connected with all of them, but also to advertise you and your brand. So it shows that you're involved in what's going on at the school and that the extracurricular activities like sports are important to you and that you understand that's something that's important to the teachers, the parents, and of course to the students. And this can give you lots of different opportunities as far as getting into a bulletin, maybe advertising on a uniform or at the field or something like that. So lots of different opportunities with that, and a great way for you to meet the parents, meet the teachers, and get your brand out there. Something else you could do would be to help out with the PTA. So parents are obviously really busy this time of year, getting their kids back to school, juggling that with their jobs and things like that. And they utilize the PTA meetings as a way to be involved in the school, make sure they know the teachers and that kind of stuff. So that's a great way. Even if you can't join the PTA, you can do things like sponsor refreshments for the meetings and things like that. And again, that's gonna show that you care, but also get you involved and give you that chance to start building those relationships. And with each of these opportunities, a really important thing to focus on is your branding. So you want to brand yourself. I always recommend wearing a name tag or some sort of branded shirt, something like that with your logo, your name, all of that on it. But also if you're dropping by goodies or promotional items, brand yourself and make sure that your logo and contact information is on the stuff that you're dropping by. So, you know, obviously consumables are good. Like I said, donuts, you know, tacos, cookies, things like that. Make sure you're leaving some business cards too, and maybe some flyers about the different programs you offer, pens, you know, koozies, things like that that you can brand are gonna get you exponential results for the marketing you're doing. And we're using the word sponsor a lot. And so obviously we understand in this industry that that means spending some money. So if you want to help cut the costs for what you're doing, one thing I highly recommend is getting some of your preferred partners, your lenders, your warranty people, other people that you work hand in hand with in your business, and get them to help, foot some of the cost for that. Obviously, they're going to get great exposure from it too, and y'all can kind of buddy up, and if you're going to go out to the school, you can go together. It makes it a little bit more fun, but then also it helps cut the cost. And in addition to the pop buys at the schools, the sports teams and sponsorships, and the PTA meetings, you also want to focus your marketing that you're doing on social media, whether it be blog posts, videos, which you guys know how much I love the videos, but tailor those to back to school topics. So you just get on Google, you can research lots of different topics for back to school, you can post articles about things that are school related, things like that. But if your marketing is showing topics like that right now, it's highly likely that you're going to get a lot more clicks and a lot more visibility and exposure on those posts that you're doing or those sponsored ads that you're doing. So according to NAR, actually 60% of home buyers cited that schools and school districts were one of the top factors as to why they chose or were looking in the area they were going to buy in. And actually 50% of them were willing to go above their budget if it meant getting into the right school with the right school district. So back to school can be a really great time for you to really target your marketing, really take those topics that are important to people as they're, you know, making those moves and get yourself a lot more exposure. And even though the summer months tend to be some of our busiest months in the real estate industry, that doesn't mean that the marketing efforts that you do right now can't really, really make your fall and your winter a lot busier than typical years. So if you focus and you target your marketing right now, it really can help you through those months. I hope these few little back to school real estate marketing tips help. Put them into action, and I'll see you guys on the next video.